Hello students, in this video we are going to discuss the co-occurrence matrix. Before we start the co-occurrence matrix, first we define the texture. So textures are complex visual patterns composed of specially organized entities that have characteristics like brightness, color, shape, size, etc. Texture is a description of the special arrangement of color or intensities in an image or a selected region of an image. In other words, the textures refer to a variations in the gray level or color. If gray level is constant in the object, then there is a no texture. If the gray level varies significantly within the image or object, then object is said to have a texture. So there are different approaches used in image processing to describe the texture of a region. Statistical approach, structural model, filters. So here in this we discuss the statistical approach. So there are different types. So first order, texture measures are statistics calculated from the original image values like variance and do not consider pixel neighbor relationship. Second order measures consider the relationship between groups of two pixels in the original image. Third and higher order textures are theoretically possible but not commonly implemented due to calculation time and interpretation difficulty. So gray level co-occurrence matrix. So gray, it is a one such technique which gives us not only intensity values but also the distribution of the intensities. So before we generate the co-occurrence matrix, first we discuss the features of the properties of the GLCM, that is the gray level co-occurrence matrix. So it is a square matrix, that is it has same number of rows and columns as quantization level of image should be resampled to not more than 4 bit, because if it is greater than 4 bit, then the calculation becomes the tedious. It can be calculated at any angle, that is direction, and at any offset. So we can calculate neighboring pixel at the 0 degree, 45, 90 degree, 135, 180, 225 degree, 270 degree and 315. Usually the co-occurrence matrix is calculated in horizontal direction, that is the 0 degree. Next property, it is a symmetrical around ground diagonal. Symmetry will be achieved if each pair pixel is counted twice, once forward and one backward. East and west, horizontal matrix, north and south, it is a vertical matrix. Symmetrical matrix is to be normalized to convert it into probabilities. Now we take the one example to generate the co-occurrence matrix of the following image. It is a 4x4 image, but in this 4x4 image, there are gray levels like 0, 1, 2, 3. So, n is equal to 4, number of gray levels are 4. So, we have to generate the, generate the co-occurrence matrix size is 4x4. So, that means the number of size of the co-occurrence matrix is decided by the number of gray levels in the image. The element, see, this is the co-occurrence matrix. So number of columns 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and number of rows 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is the 4x4 co-occurrence matrix. If it is C00 means number of the element C00 means number of times gray level 0 appears to the right of gray level 0. Similarly, if it is C22, that is number of times the gray level 2 appears to the right of gray level 2. If it is like this, if it is C30, that is the number of times 0 appears to the right of gray level 3. So we calculate the values like this. So First, we calculate the C00, first element C00. That is the number of times the 0 appear to the right of gray level 0. So we start from the top left corner. So it is 0, neighboring is also 0. So the one pair is there. So 0, 1, this is condition is not satisfied. 1, 1 condition is not satisfied. This is 0 and this is 0. Condition is satisfied. So this is second pair. So 0, 1 condition is not satisfied. 1, 1 condition is not satisfied. In the third row, again condition is not satisfied. And in the fourth row again, there is no condition satisfied. So C00 element value was substituted by the 2 number. So similarly, we find the next element, that is C01. That is the number of times gray level 1 appears to the right of 0. So here 00 not appear. So 0 right is 1. So this is first pair. 1 1 condition is not satisfied. 00 again not satisfied. 0 right it is 1. So this condition is satisfied. This is second pair. 1 1 condition is not satisfied. 02 again not satisfied. So for 01 element, C01 element, the value we substitute here 2. 2 pairs we get. Now third is 02 element C02. That is the number of times the gray level 2 appears to the right of 0. So in the first row there is no 2, no condition is satisfied. In the second also there is no 2, no condition is satisfied. In the second, third row there is gray level 0, there is a 2. That means this pair is satisfied. So first pair is satisfied, again 2 2 is not satisfied, and in the fourth row there is a no condition satisfied. So for 02 on the element, only one pair is there, so we substitute 1. Now for the next C03, that is the number of times the gray level 3 appears to the right of 0. So here, so in the first row there is no 3, in the second also no 3, then in the third also there is no. So in the fourth row there is no condition is satisfied. So for the C03 element, we write the substitute the value 0. So this is for the first row. In this way, we calculate all the pairs for the all the elements of the co-occurrence matrix. So we get the values like this. So for the C10, see there is no condition satisfied. So we write here 0. For 11 C11, see this is one pair, again this is second pair, so we write here 2. So for C12, so there is no pair, condition is satisfied, so we write here 0. And for 13, again there is no pair in this image, so we write here 0. Similarly for 20, no condition is there, no pair is there. For 21, again there is no pair. Now for 22, see for 22, this is first pair. For this 22 is again second pair, and this 22 is the third pair. So we write here value 3. And for 23, the only one pair, that is 23. So number of times 3 appears to the gray level 3 appears to the right of 2. So only one pair. So we write here 1. So for 30, 31, 32, all there is no pair, so we write all the values are 0. For 33, only one pair is there, so we write here 1. So in this way, we generate the co-occurrence matrix. Now find the symmetry of the co-occurrence matrix. So for this, we have to take the transpose copy of the GLCM. That is, row makes the column and column. So here the first row 2210 become the first column, that is 2210. Second row again becomes 0200, here becomes the second column. Third row again becomes the third column, and fourth row becomes the fourth column. So in this way we get the transpose of the coherence matrix image, and we add both the images and we get the symmetry of the GLCM. So see, this is 2, this is 2, so here we get the 4. So in this way we get the symmetry of the GLCM. Now we find the normalized GLCM. For normalizing the GLCM, divide each element symmetry GLCM by the sum of all elements. So symmetry GLCM, if you add all the elements of this matrix, so this addition or summation, we get the sum of all the elements is equal to 24. So if you divide each and every element of the symmetry GLCM by 24, we get the normalized GLCM. So 4 divided by 24, we get the 0.167. Similarly, 2 divided by 24, we get the 0.083. So in this way, we get the normalized GLCM, that is normalized coherence matrix. So in normalized gray level coherence matrix, diagonal elements represent the pixel pair with no gray level differences. High values in diagonal show homogeneous area, or we can say it is a low contrast cells. One cell away from diagonal represents pixel pair with a difference of one gray level. Values in cells two away from diagonal show how many pixels have two gray level difference. Further away from diagonal, the greater difference between pixel gray level. So this is about the coherence matrix. Thank you.